Hi, Joan. Welcome to the Meet the Brain series. Thank you for coming.
You're welcome.
So, what is your research interest?
We are mainly interested in how people use visual information to do things in the world. Basically, from very simple things like catching a ball to more complex decisions and their uncertainty and risk.
And what is exciting about it?
People make is amazingly precise in doing perceptual tasks. So they, for example, they can catch a ball very easily, very complicated flies. And we have to explain this precision, and according to what we know about the brain, it's not easy to explain that level of precision.
And how do you reach your research goals?
So we always start with models to guide the design, and then we collect data, experimental data, behavioral with virtual reality, and then we test this data against the models.
And who are your partners in your research?
Well, we have international collaborations all around Europe, basically Netherlands, UK, Germany, France, and also in the States.
So what are you most looking forward to?
Well, actually, what I'm looking forward is to every time to predict more and more the performance in complex situations. So get out a bit of the lab and apply the models to more complexity.
So, how do you think your research can change the world?
I think we can help make better decisions because we are concerned with decision making. Although it's a perceptual level we are interested in, that the same very principles they can apply to all kind of decision making.
And what other disciplines do you think synergize well with your research?
Certainly biology is very close. But also I would say economy, because economy is about decision making and the risk. So I believe the same principles apply when we make decisions in different fields.
So in that line, do you think your research have real world applications?
It could have. We are basically involved in basic research, but we have an eye on applicability, and we could really make burst the learning of perceptual decision making, you know, by speeding up the process of otherwise very, very lengthy process of learning to, like, you know, deal with a task like catching a ball. It takes a long time for children, so, and for elite sports. We could burst this and speed up the process.
So what's next in your field of research?
Well, I think what is next is to see how our perceptual systems will adapt and respond to new realities, which is basically virtual realities, mixed realities, augmented realities, because this will challenge a system, the perceptual system, which has evolved for millions of years. And in a couple of decades, this will be challenged because new information breaking all the laws that we know will happen.
Who or what is your inspiration?
I like to read and listen other scientists from other fields. That really lose my concepts and makes me make a really connections that I will otherwise not really thought before.
If you could have a coffee with a scientist from the past, who would it be?
I think Galileo. We made sure the coffee is good. He was Italian.
What's the best thing that has happened in your career?
Well, many things, but I have to say that what really comforts me in my scientific career is to have very good students. So after having really good students, that you see they are really motivated, really pays off.
And how many countries have you visited during your research career?
Well, many. I cannot really count on them, but many, many in Europe, in the States.
Where would you go for a sabbatical?
Somewhere calm, so I can have time to think deeper, because science needs more thinking. It's slow cooking science. Solid science must be slow cooking.
What do you think will be the next big thing in neuroscience?
The next big thing in neuroscience, I hope it won't be that long that we can see. I think will be the fact that we can regenerate neurons, but these neurons, the regenerated neurons, can really communicate and connect with existing neurons. This will be, of course, the end of all the neurodiseases that are degenerative of the disease, but also will be a bar for human intelligence.
And finally, what would you like to say to the world?
Well, I will say that people should dare to be a more personal scientist, so that they, when they face these strong opinions, that they really regard them as hypotheses, not as a validity, and that they look for evidence to reject these strong opinions. So in that sense, I guess the bad consequences of post-truth will be highly diminished.
Okay, thank you for your answers, and thank you for coming.
You're welcome.